Hello everybody again on Simplifodia YouTube channel, and thank you for your great feedback about our previous videos. Today we'll explain the HACCP, H-A-C-C-P, which stands for Hazard Analysis and Critical Control Points. Today we'll support our training with an example, the orange juice. Before getting to the example, we must have a small brief about the HACCP. The HACCP system was first introduced in the 1960s in NASA to ensure food safety for astronauts. The application of HACCP system, in addition to the prerequisite programs and the GMPs, the good manufacturing practices, provides the best protection for food. The application of the HACCP system ensures that the company controls all the types of hazard, if it is physical hazard, chemical hazard, or biological hazard, or other types of hazards as previously mentioned. Our example today was the orange juice. We'll train ourselves how to can make an HACCP plan for any food we want to make a HACCP plan for it. First of all, we must understand that 12 steps to develop a HACCP plan are divided to 5 primary steps and 7 basic principles. Today we'll explain in details the 5 primary steps for a HACCP plan. First step, assemble the HACCP team. Number 2, describe the product components and storage conditions. Number 3, the intended use and consumers. Number 4, draw a flow diagram to describe the product process steps. Number 5, on-site confirmation of this flow diagram. Our example was the orange juice. So the HACCP team for this orange juice in this company will be from different departments: top management, quality and food safety, production, sales, maintenance, and purchasing. And we'll understand later on what the benefits and the importance of each department for those departments. Number 2, for the orange juice, we must have a description for the product, components, and storage condition. For example, this orange juice, our natural pasteurized orange juice, this is the description, and its components was orange plus water. Specifications, it's sugar-free, and methods of preservation, stored in the refrigerator in temperature from 4 to 8 Celsius. This is an example, okay? We also can mention how many calories the millimeters of the bottle itself of the orange juice. Number 3, the intended use and consumers. The intended use, we can mention that it can be drank directly from the bottle. The user category, for example, from age of 2 years old, and not recommended for patients with pressure. This is an example, okay? We must mention if there is any medical precautions must be mentioned on the label of the product, and the expire periods from 14 to 15 days. Number 2 and number 3 in the HACCP plan, mainly all the data written on the label of the product. So first thing to be understood in the flow diagram, that we are receiving all the orange from a well and trusted supplier of orange fruits by harvesting this orange fruits. But the mentioned first step was the receiving of orange. You must take care and to focus on the shape of the step, okay, and numbering of the step. For example, number 1, receiving of orange. Number 2, sorting of orange. This shape was rhombus shape. It means that there is a decision if it is good orange fruits or bad orange fruits. Number 3, washing of this good orange fruits and the drain of the waste water. Then this orange fruits will be squeezed out. Step number 4. Number 5, filtering to remove any peel or seed. Number 6, concentration, because it's a natural juice. Number 7, reconstitution by adding water. Number 8, pasteurization, heat, then sudden cooling to kill any microorganism. Number 9, bottles filling. You must take care For example, between differentiation of step number 5, filtering, it's a rectangle, and step number 8, pasteurization, it's a document shape flow chart diagram. Okay, you must take care of these diagrams. Let's continue. Number 10, the bottles capping. Number 11, x-ray. Okay, to make inspection if there is any residues in the bottle. Number 12, dating the bottles. Number 13, packing the bottles. And number 14, arranging on pallets. Number 15, the storage of these pallets. And we must take care of the temperature control in these warehouses. And final step, the distribution. This is a brief of our flow diagram. Number 1, receiving of orange fruits. Number 2, sorting of orange and sarambas. I have mentioned before this decision, so there will be waste. Number 3, washing. You can find that waste shape was rounded rectangle. It means last step. So after waste, there is no any step in our production process. Number 3, washing. Number 4, squeeze out. Number 5, filtering the juice. And there is a waste also. Number 6, concentration. Number 7, reconstitution by adding water. Number 8, pasteurization. Number 9, bottles filling. 10, bottles capping. X-ray. Here is a step in this X-ray. If the X-ray mentioned that some of the bottles have residues, we must make an investigation and put again all the bottles to the filtering steps to have the steps again and again. Okay, dating the bottles. Number 13, backing the bottles. Number 14, arranging the pallets. Number 15, storing. Number 16, distribution. If you have a wide look about this flow diagram, you will find the different shapes of the flow chart diagrams. Number 2, decision. Number 1, starting of production step. Number 5, filtering, it's a normal process step. Number 8, pasteurization, it's a document. And number 11, also it's a document flow diagram shape. So we must take care of this all flow diagram shapes. Later on, we will explain the 7 principles of HACCP, which must be memorized in this order. Conduct a hazard analysis for each step. Okay, identify the critical control points, establish critical limits, monitor our CCPs, establish corrective action, and verification. Number 7, record keeping or documentation. The next 7 basic principles for HACCP will be explained in the upcoming videos, but you must memorize them, must in order, okay, to be easily understood while explaining in the upcoming videos. And best of luck of all of you, and sorry for taking long time in explaining, but this, there is a homework for you. You can mention any food you want to mention it, and you can make search on Google or any browsing website to have its HACCP plan, and you read it and understand each step of this flow diagram. Later on, we'll have this same flow diagram because it missed some data. We'll explain it later on. What is the CCPs? What is the OPRPs? All the control measures in each step of production, and all the control and hazard analysis in each ingredient used in this orange juice. Thank you again for all your support, and if you like the content, don't forget to subscribe the channel. And thank you again, and best of luck of all of you from Simply Foodia YouTube channel. Thank you.